In this video, which is an excerpt of a keynote address Chris Bianco gave at Pizza Expo, he gives many wonderful golden nuggets of advice for any chef and pizza maker. And one of the takeaways for me was, he said, I learn things by burning things. Here's Chris.
Yeah, I'm always surprised when people care about anything I have to say. With that being said, the older I get, the more that it does matter, I think, what we tell each other about looking back, what will we do over again, what will we start, what will we change, what will we keep the same, and what will we do more of. And I think for anybody who doesn't know about my life, not that anybody should, but I grew up in, I was born in the Bronx, New York, and when I was about 7 years old, we moved to a little town, Ossining, New York, just up the Hudson. And, my parents were born here in the States. My grandparents are from Italy and Puglia. And like every kid at some point in their life in my neighborhood, got a job after school at the pizzeria. It was a little pizzeria called Aldo's, and I was 13. And I remember folding boxes. And I tell this story a lot, if so have you heard it. But I remember folding boxes that said, you try the rest, not try the best. And the reality was it wasn't really the best. But it was no better than the other best in our neighborhood. We all used the same flours, bromated, enriched. You know, tomato sauce came in the cans. The mozzarella came in blocks. And, you know, my job, I think I had grinded blocks of mozzarella and carried flour from the mixer to the dough from the mixer up to the walk-in. But years later, that story I constantly go to because I think that word best is very fleeting and been somewhat disruptive in my life. I never set out to be, you know, and I don't think anything I've ever done has been better than other things that are optimum. Like in our world, I always look, even like in this room, there's people much smarter, talented, definitely better looking than anything I've been able to done. But for whatever reason, I've been very fortunate, and I try to take that good fortune and share it with others as much as I can. For that, I'm very grateful, and I'm very grateful to anybody that came and to my little shoebox of a space where when I finally moved to Phoenix, I'll jump in the story now. It'll be fast, so it won't be that painful, I promise. But when I moved to Phoenix, Arizona, I left New York in 1985. I love New York, but I just wanted to go anywhere. That was, other than a few trips to Italy when I was a kid, I didn't get to travel too much. For some reason, I ended up in Phoenix, Arizona. I didn't know a soul. I started a little business out of my apartment, making fresh mozzarella and pasta. And I'd sell it to a couple of Italian restaurants there in town. And I started a little business also making pizza, like grandma style at people's houses. And then one customer I was doing that, a guy was from Venice named Marino Godi, had a, when he was building his house, the workers built a wood oven outside, and I said, hey man, can I do these pizzas in the wood oven outside for this party? And I did them, and a couple people liked them that was there, and one guy on the grocery store said, hey man, if you ever want to get serious about this, I'll lease you 200 square feet in the back of this grocery store. And in 1988, I opened up Pizzeria Bianco in that little space. From there, the philosophy, though evolving, has been really similar, which was studying what makes good things good. And what I mean by that is not just, the best ingredients or the highest quality, which should be a given to make good things. They can still be incredibly humble, but it's finding that tipping point of compromise, which is incredibly important. I got into the tomato business by accident. I didn't ever, want to be in it. It evolved from a relationship, which You know, my partner in that one, a guy named Rob DiNapoli, came to me one day, showed up at my pizzeria, and he had great tomatoes, and I was already using great ones from Italy, but we were able to, do something that we thought kind of like wine. In my cellar, in the restaurants, there's wines from all the best wine regions in the world. And the best, no better than the other best, whether it was from, you know, Chianti or Sicily or in Spain or Argentina or Napa or Sonoma. And I was thinking, well, why shouldn't, you know, tomatoes or grain be of that same way? So sometimes the one thing I like to say here is, first of all, I love Italy. And even though I'm a somewhat of a localist, I'm definitely a globalist. And I find food at the point of compromise. I still, you know, my restaurants run through about 6 wheels of Reggiano a week. And I love it, and it can come to us uncompromised and fantastic and delicious. I still love some of the best San Marzano tomatoes, and I love the tomatoes we grow in Northern California, which are special as well. We hope that they're on a shelf next to some of the best ones. So when you open, whether it's a bottle of wine, a can of preserved tomatoes that are grown in good earth organically, that you're not just tasting something that, you know, both are delicious. But when I go to someone's home or I go to someone's house, I want to see what they serve me. Not so much what they flew in and they FedExed in. And sometimes things that happen, I have no judgment. I'm saying I just wanted to give you something of this place, wherever that place was. Like, and I'm still moved by that. I think, you know, sometimes as chefs, if we're ever invited to someone's home, you know, sometimes they say, oh, I'm nervous cooking for you. I'm like, well, you know, if there's a piece of toast and you make it, you know, with love, I mean, we're grateful to have it. And I know all of you in our industry, we rarely even get to eat sitting down. So that's a treat as well. But, you know, at the end of this, I'm happy to answer, you know, or not even the end of it. In a little bit, I'll do some Q&A because I do, you know, many of you I've been fortunate enough to bump into over the years. And I try to answer most any question that you have, you know, because the questions I had starting out. I had no forum when I opened up. I had no Pizza Expo to go to. I had, you know, I learned things by burning things. You know, I learned things by you know, tasting what I wanted to, like understanding crispy. Even our young chefs now, it's more of a, you know, cooking school is great. Everything is great. But I think the best investment you can make in yourself is, you know, what do you think?
Thank you so much, Chris, for your heartfelt presentation at Pizza Expo. Discover more about Chris and Pizzeria Bianco by going to pizzeriabianco.com. He has a wonderful book called Bianco, Pizza, Pasta, and Other Food I Like. And you can also check out Bianco DiNapoli Organic Whole Peeled and Crushed Tomatoes. I'll put links below this video. If you're interested in the pizza business, I can't say enough about attending Pizza Expo. For more information, go to pizzaexpo.com. And while you're here, if you could show a little pizza love and subscribe, pizza on earth, goodwill to all.